these three things have been really helping me out with my mental health in terms of how happy and how connected I am feeling throughout the day, and I really want to share them with you. Hi, my name is Himmel, and on this channel, we explore ideas and strategies around mental health, self-improvement, and lifestyle so that we can live more happier and more meaningful lives. So if any of that interests you, please make sure that you do chuck us a sub. That will really help us out. Now, these three things that I'm going to share with you may not necessarily be things that you would have thought would have helped with your mental health, but they've been working extremely well for me. So the first one is keep being busy. I'm the type of person where if I do not have things to do, then I spiral very quickly. I feel like my life really applies to this quote, this metaphor, really well. An idle mind is a devil's workshop. When I have nothing to do, then my mind will drift towards very negative behaviors like unhealthy eating, sleeping really late, and waking up in the middle of the afternoon. I also talk very negatively to myself. I say things like, I'm worthless, I'm not worthy enough, I'm not deserving of this. It's just bad all around. So what I've kind of done is I've tried to keep myself really busy. So I've picked like habits and behaviors and things that I can do that would make me feel like I've got a lot of things that I need to get through throughout the day. For example, running this YouTube channel, hitting the gym, tutoring a few students, going outside and hanging out with people. These are things that take up time and energy, but they're very positive things. So it fills my mental headspace with a lot of good, healthy and positive thoughts. So it ultimately makes me feel a lot better. Now, another thing that I'm doing is making sure that I have time to myself. Now, the other side of being extremely busy is not having enough time for yourself. And I can very easily go extremely busy or extremely do nothing. So there needs to be like a really good balance. And obviously, you know, you gotta find out what works for you. But for me, it's about scheduling certain little blocks of time throughout the day or even throughout the week if I've got a really hectic week where I can just spend time with myself and do things that I love doing. For example, like hitting the gym, doing my daily sadhana, which is like my daily practice. Maybe talking to one or two friends that I'm really close with, or even just sitting around and not really doing anything at all, apart from like watching anime or a bit of Netflix and not having to think too much. I see this time to myself as a way of me recharging and reconnecting with myself so that when I get back to whatever it is that I need to be doing, I can keep going with energy and enthusiasm. Now, the last thing that I've been trying to do a lot of recently is authentic and vulnerable conversations. Now, you might be thinking, how does this have anything to do or help with mental health? Well, my experience of this has actually been quite interesting. I found that it has encouraged me to live a lot more truthfully and be a little bit more open about my life and what's going on. You know, it's scary at first because I had feelings of like, you know, I don't know if I'll be accepted. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be cast out if I tell someone this. And so it's like really, really daunting to be open with other people. But if anything, I found myself being a lot more connected, not only with them, because they feel like, you know, they can share the dark sides of their life as well and what's going on in their life as well with me. I'm not only feeling connected to them, but I'm also feeling really connected with myself as well. I feel like I don't need to pretend to be someone or something that I'm not. I don't need to hide me, who I am with all my flaws and whatnot. And you feel like you're not pretending. So all that energy is not being taken up by trying to be or pretend to be something else. You're just well and truly just being yourself. Now, I think this whole topic should have like a video on its own, but these are my thoughts on it for now. It's been really helping me out. So that's it. That's three things that have been really helping me out with my mental health. Let me know what's been helping you out. Share it in the comments. I'd love to learn from you. But before you leave, please make sure that you do like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Check out this video over here. That might be of interest to you and might help in one way or another. And I hope it does. And I guess I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Where is the... So we'll use a lens cap this time to kind of close this off.